In the distance is Mount Elbrus, the tallest mountain of Caucasia. The road now finally crosses this mountain range. The highway, commonly known as the Georgian Military Road, crosses the Caucasus mountain range. It is a 208-kilometer highway connecting Orzhonikidze city of Soviet Russia in the northern foothills of Caucasia and Tbilisi city of Georgia in the southern foothills. This road was first opened in 1801 by the Imperial Russian Army for military purposes, but today it is open for ordinary use and serves as the main artery of transportation on which the economy of Caucasia depends. The spot on which this cross stands forms the watershed between the north and the south of Caucasia. The cross shows that the area beyond here belongs to a Christian country. This cross is said to have been erected in the 11th century by King David IV of Georgia in the southern side of Caucasia. Going down the pass southward, one enters the Georgian Soviet Socialist Republic. Christianity was already established as the state religion in Georgia in the 4th century, and it continues today under the rule of the Soviet Socialist system. Along the Silk Road, we have traveled from a Buddhist country to an Islamic community, and now we have entered the world of Christianity for the first time in our journey. In Vadzia, situated south of the Georgian Republic, lies an impregnable town which abounds in caverns. A Persian historian admired it thus: "It is as unapproachable as Alexandrian walls and the fortress of the Khyber Pass. This is a miracle of Georgia." 150 meters high against the rocky mountainside, as many as 2,000 caverns have been hollowed out. These caverns are said to have been made in the 12th century. In those days, the Christians in Georgia were constantly under persecution and attacks by the followers of other religions and other nations. The people in Georgia tried to protect their lives and the freedom of their faith by building this impregnable cavern city. 600 monks used to live in these caverns, but during the time of emergency, 50,000 people would entrench themselves here to continue their living. But in 1551, Vadzia finally fell before the persistent attacks by the Persian army, and it was completely destroyed later in 1578 by the Turkish army. The people of Vadzia were plundered of their property and the cavern city perished. This is the Assumption Church, built in the center of the town. Remarkable wall paintings, which tell us of those ancient times, now remain only in this church. This series of wall paintings depict the life of Jesus Christ. Inside this cavern temple, the culture of Christian Georgia blossomed beautifully. The people of Georgia seem to have visited this church for worship whenever the occasion called, and regained their peace of mind looking at these paintings. The wall paintings in the chapel speak of the history of the battles of different races which developed on the stage of Caucasus.